The result was a low-grade breast carcinoma, in other words, cancer. In December 2020, an 80-year-old woman came to our surgeon. She accidentally hit her left breast and groped for a mass which she believed to be a hematoma. The surgeon didn't like the bumpy surface of the formation. He sent the patient for an ultrasound examination. He usually sends almost all patients for ultrasound with various formations, seals, signs of inflammation, with enlarged lymphatic nodes, with implants, and also within the framework of a checkup. In my opinion, he is absolutely right. Not only because I am an ultrasound diagnostician, but mainly because ultrasound is a simple, quick and safe method to determine the condition of breast tissues and identify tumors, cysts, mastitis, ruptured breast implants, etc. Ultrasound helps surgeons with puncture and biopsy of breast tumors and cysts. An ultrasound examination of our patient revealed a large tumor with indistinct, uneven contours, with vessels invading the formation. The surgeon performed an extended resection of the tumor and referred the tumor for histology. The result was a low-grade breast carcinoma, in other words, cancer. Has the cancer developed after the hit? No, very unlikely. Rather, it was the message from the universe. My dear person, finally, pay attention to your left breast. What I want to tell you, nowadays the rhythm of life has accelerated so much that women have completely forgotten about self-examination of their mammary glands. Breast self-exam could not replace a physical exam of the breasts performed by your doctor. It cannot replace any special imaging tests as well, such as ultrasound, mammography, CT, MRI, and others. But it can be a simple way to find breast cancer early, so that treatment will be started earlier. Unfortunately, the American Cancer Society doesn't recommend breast self-exam as a screening tool for women. I am deeply convinced that this is a good and useful diagnostic method that is available to every woman. And it's also free of charge, so why not? Breast self-exam should be performed once a month, about a week after the start of your menstrual cycle. I mean from the 5th to the 12th day from the first day of the onset of menstruation, because at that time there is no soreness and swelling of the breasts. If you have menopause or menstrual cycles become irregular, you can perform breast self-exam once a month at any fixed time. It is extremely important to conduct self-exams thoroughly every month. This procedure can be done in 3 steps. In the first step, stand in front of a mirror, place your hands on your waist and carefully examine your breasts. Pay attention to the symmetry of the breast, their size, shape and deformations, swelling, scar retraction, nipple retraction, and also skin changes, or whether there is redness, peeling, rash, irregularities like lemon peel, etc. Don't forget to look carefully at your breasts with your hands up, because when you raise your hands, the mammary glands seem to pull on so that the scars and deformities become better visible. In the second step, you need to feel the lymphatic nodes in your armpits. To do this, put your left hand on your waist. Insert the fingers of your right hand deeply into the left axillary region. Then slide slowly from top to bottom. The lymphatic nodes either should not be felt at all or should be small, up to 1 cm, painless and mobile, I mean not adhered to the skin. I also recommend probing the supraclavicular and subclavian regions. The collarbones or clavicles are the protruding topmost bones on your chest. Slide your hands from your shoulder joint toward the middle of your body on the left side of your chest. First above the collarbone, then below the collarbone. After that, do the same with your right side. In the last step, feel your breasts while lying down. Raise your left hand and carefully feel your left breast with your right hand. Move your fingertips smoothly all over your breast in a circle from the periphery to the nipple or from top to bottom. Explore every inch of your breasts. At the end, carefully feel the nipple. Is there any liquid from the nipple? And what kind of liquid it is? Watery, whitish, yellowish, purulent or bloody? Examine your right chest in the same way. You can feel your breasts in the shower with soapy, wet fingers. This is not only useful, but also very enjoyable. There is a wonderful exercise for breasts in the shower. With soapy hands, slowly sweep over your breast from bottom to top and from periphery to the center of your body. This excellent exercise would be not only a diagnostic tool for the presence of induration and formations, but also good for the prevention of lymphostasis and ptosis or prolapse of the breasts. But if you find something in your breasts, please do not panic, consult your doctor first. Maybe this is just a local induration of the breast tissue. Maybe it's a breast cancer. In any case, consult your doctor and go through all necessary examinations. Take care of your body, mind, and breasts.